So welcome to the second day of step-by-step SQL tutorial for data analytics in software or web development. Yesterday we studied about inserting values in a database. After creating a database, we learned how to create tables. Then we learned how to insert data into tables using SQL query. Also, we learned how to insert values in the tables using the online interface of phpMyAdmin. The web forms were there. We also learned how to show some values from table using the select statement. So, select statement is used to show some values. So, today we are going to discuss about the where clause, the where conditions, and there will be some operators associated with it. So those operators will be used to show data based on certain conditions, right? So for we have installed a more complex database, so make sure your XAMPP is running and Apache and MySQL are in running condition. Simply click admin. In your admin section, so for more complex queries, we have a database called Northwind. This is a very famous database that is used for educational purpose. This database represents an enterprise resource planning system. This is database of some organization, some trading organization you can say. So in a trading organization, you trade products, so you have product table. Every product belongs to certain categories. So here are the product categories like beverages, condiments, confections, dairy products, grains, cereals, etc. And these are the products. So chai, chang, anise syrup, chef Anton's. So these are the name of products. So you have products here. Also you have customers, a table named customers. So in your customers table you have customer ID, name of the company they belong to, their contact name, their contact title, address, city, etc. You also have the name of your employees, the employee of the organization. So you have the first name, last name, title. You have the designations also, that this particular person is sales representative, vice president, etc. All employees have certain territories, and this table represents the territory of those employees. Now this is linked data. In this table, the territory ID is only there. If we'll click on territory ID, then it will give us that Georgetown is the territory description. So we can tell that the employee with employee code of, so here the employee with employee ID of 2 belongs to this territory, and the name of this territory is Boston, right? So this is linked data. We will discuss about linked data in great deal in the later parts. We will discuss how we can link two tables together, or three tables, or four tables, right? For today, we are going to do some basic queries on these databases. Now, for our analysis purpose, let's take this customers table. And in the customers table, we are going to apply SQL. So select star from customers. This is the first query that we are going to test today. So select star from customers and click go. It will give us all the rows of customer table and all the columns of customer table.
Okay.
Now we can see that customers belong to various countries and various cities. So we can pick the name of any particular country and check whether any particular customer belongs to that country or not. So for that we use where clause. So you have to write select star from customers, where
country,
click on country and click on this arrow. This will bring the country column in your query, where country is equal to. Now country is a varchar data or a string data. If you are familiar with Python or any other programming, then you know the string data is written in single quotes. So where country is equal to, let's say Germany, this will give you some data. So this will give you, this will give you contact name with all the details of this particular person, of these customers, where country is Germany, right?
Yeah.
Now we can see that in Germany people belong to various cities also. Means all customers are not from same city. So if we want someone from Berlin, right? So, or if we want someone to be a sales representative, so we want, what is our query? We want people from Germany who are sales representative. So click on country, place your cursor here, click on country and where country is equal to Germany. So when we were studying Python, or you must have studied any programming language, so in that programming language there are logical operators. Logical operators are mainly AND and OR. So we are going to discuss the first logical operator, AND. So AND operator. AND operator is like AND gate. If you have both conditions as zero, then AND operator will give zero output. If one condition is zero and other one is zero, one condition is high and other one is low, then also the output will be low. In the third case, if first condition is low, second condition is high, then also the output will be low. If both the conditions are true, then only the answer will be 1. So this is how AND operator works. And we can verify the same funda here also. So where country is equal to Germany and contact title is equal to sales representative. Now click go. So now we have all those candidates, all those customers who are sales representative and they belong to Germany, right? Now we are getting all the columns here. Suppose we want only certain columns, so what we can do is we can copy our query. We can copy our query and again write the SQL query, that where contact title is equal to sales representative. Now instead of star we can give, suppose we want customer ID and company name and contact, only three columns. So click on these three columns and simply click this arrow. So what will our query be? Select column 1, column 2, column 3 from table, where column 6 is equal to something and column 7 is equal to something.
Right?
So this will give us some answer. So in this particular answer, now we are getting only the desired columns. It is not giving us all the columns. We are getting only the desired column. So this is how SQL works. You can either choose any particular column, you can either choose a list of any particular column, or you can choose all columns. You can filter data on the basis of values. So we are not getting country and contact title here, but on the basis of country and contact title we are getting the values.
I'm not getting
the. Now the next topic is, so we have discussed about AND operation. Now the next thing is OR operation. So we can take the same set of values. So OR is just opposite of AND. 0, 0 is 0.
And everything is
one. And other things are because it works on if either of the condition, any condition is true, then the output will be true. So 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 1 in binary. Also, here it is multiplication. And it is multiplication. So 0 into 0 is 0, 1 into 0 is also 0, 0 into 1 is also 0, but 1 into 1 is 1. So in AND operation there is multiplication, in OR operation there is addition, right? So we can write the same query
with OR.
So select star from select star from customers where country is equal to Germany. You have to write the same thing again. Or country is equal to let's say Mexico. So select star from, so we want all the customers from who belong to either Germany or Mexico.
So most probably kisko prefer karenge.
So it will give us all the values
of contact title.
Yeah, and
our country
is equal to Mexico. So, in the next case.